everyone. Jeff Yastine here. Make sure to subscribe to my Twitter feed at Jeff Yastine, and also on Facebook, subscribe to our Wealth Press YouTube channel, and make sure to share the video if you like it. So let's talk about Snowflake, symbol S-N-O-W. Now, this is a software and a data platform company. It made its stock market debut yesterday, and it more than doubled in value on the very first trade of the day. Now, I'll have more to say about Snowflake, the company, in just a moment. But, you know, like for me, I get interviewed occasionally in the media, and people ask me questions and what have you. So an interview asked me yesterday, in fact, if there was anything that I truly hate. And, you know, I had trouble thinking of it. I mean, hate is a strong word. It's not a very good emotion. It takes too much energy to sustain hate. You know, it's not a positive thing. But if there is one thing that I hate, it's these news headlines that scream that, you know, such and such company, in this case Snowflake, rocketed 112% as Snowflake did in its first day of trading. In my opinion, there's nothing worse, nothing more damaging to your psyche and to your long-term success as an investor and trader than seeing those kinds of headlines. Those headlines, to me, are saying, hey, look at these people at Snowflake. Look how rich they got in one day. Now, I think it's great that they got rich. I think our system of capitalism, which has changed over time and will continue to change and evolve, is the greatest in the world and will remain that way. But when you read those headlines, you know there's a little voice in your head that's saying, you know what, I'm not rich, or I'm not as rich as I would like to be, and I want to get truly rich in a day, or if I'm a long-term investor, in a week or two, just like those Snowflake guys, right? That's the little voice inside many of our heads. And the next thing you know, you're throwing down a much too large portion of your savings or your kid's college fund or next month's mortgage payment or rent payment on Snowflake or some other stock that may or may not be the world's greatest new stock and may or may not appear to virtually guarantee you that the stock's going to go up and go up fast. Now, the crazy thing is, you know, at times like this, it might actually happen. You know, you might double your money in a very short time on some stock or another. So let's say that trade works out. You know what? You'll want to do it again. And that's the problem. Eventually, the merry-go-round stops. Eventually, the odds catch up with you. And usually, the merry-go-round stops at a point when you least expect it. I saw it happen in 2000. I saw it happen in 2007. And I think we're close to seeing it happen again. The math of it is that the bigger your bet is on a stock, the bigger your potential reward, and also the larger your potential risks. So let's look at Snowflake. Is it worth buying? In my opinion, it is not. Now, a word of advice. If you really want to know a lot about a publicly held company, just type in its name and then the word prospectus next to it. That's what I did for Snowflake. Now, every new IPO has to issue a prospectus before it comes out. It's a big document that almost no one reads, but everyone should, because the prospectus lays out a company's financial operations and the reasons why the company thinks that it will grow, and also the risks of that growth not happening. In Snowflake's case, it makes the case for how it can grow in the first 8 pages or so of the prospectus. The company thinks it can grow by selling access to its cloud data platform. You know, a platform is sort of like Amazon. You know, we all use Amazon's retail platform to do various different things. Snowflake wants to allow people and businesses to use its platform to basically do the same thing with data. Now, all that sounds great. The problem is there's nothing new about data and data platforms or the growth of that sector. You know, it's been out there for 15 years or so. It is already a well-marked competitive playground for Amazon and Google and Facebook and so many others. And the fact is, competition and that the company's results, Snowflake's results, could be harmed if it fails to compete well enough against these large competitors is listed on page 13 of Snowflake's prospectus. So on that point alone, from my view, Snowflake does not have an edge, and it's going up against the biggest, most ferociously competitive companies on the planet. So I do not see that as a recipe on its own for success with the stock. Now, there are 26 other pages of risks listed right there in Snowflake's IPO prospectus as well. The other two that stand out to me as most important, besides the huge amount of competition, right? There's two of them that I want to go over here. The first one is, as the company states, a limited operating history, which makes it difficult to forecast our future results. The other risk is we have a history of operating losses and may not achieve or sustain profitability in the future. Now, that's a challenge for all companies. But in the case of Snowflake, as I see it, there's really no pathway at all and none that's been laid out. Snowflake's revenue has been rising steadily. You know, that much is clear. The company's generated $133 million in revenue in its most recent quarter. But the key is when a company, any company, starts generating profits or in lieu of profits, at least positive cash flow. That's how you know a business really works. That gives investors something to focus on and something to measure the value of the stock. And that way, you know whether the price you're being asked to pay is a good value or not relative to the risk. In the six quarters that's listed in the prospectus, Snowflake has lost between $77 million and $94 million in each and every period. So it's not earning any profits. In terms of cash flow, Snowflake has yet to post a single positive quarter. On average, the company has lost around $38 million in cash flow or posted negative cash flow in each of the last six quarters. So the last thing I want to address here are the news stories, or is the news stories, leading up to the IPO, in which Snowflake is mentioned often as a Warren Buffett or Berkshire Hathaway backed stock. Now, it is true, Berkshire Hathaway has invested about $250 million at the initial IPO price. So Buffett's company would certainly have benefited in yesterday's leap in the stock. They would have doubled their money in a day. That's something, an access that we all don't have in the market. But Buffett is 90 years old, and as he has begun to acknowledge in past interviews, he's begun delegating more stock picking to a team of young, smart lieutenants whose ability to pick great stocks and beat the market for decades on end, as Buffett has done for much of his time, you know, those lieutenants and their stock picking skills have yet to be tested. Lastly, let's put this in perspective. A $250 million investment by Berkshire Hathaway amounts to less than 1% of the $146 billion it has in cash in the bank. So that'd be like you, if you had a $10,000 brokerage account, you risk $100 of your money on a stock idea that might double on its first day, as Snowflake did. But if it did not, you know what? It's not going to keep you up at night thinking about it, thinking about the loss. Unfortunately, most investors, you know, don't have access to pre-IPO deals like Snowflake and like Berkshire Hathaway did. The danger is, those successes that we read in the headline make us all want to try much harder to get risk or to get rich overnight with these aiming for that double and not getting it. So do yourself a favor and skip Snowflake's IPO. There are much better places in the stock market where you can look for value and get good, strong, long-term gains over time. If you like what I'm talking about, make sure to subscribe to us on YouTube. Follow me on social media. I'm Jeff Yastine.